I'm gonna show you what you need to clean windows. So I've got a pail of warm water, and I've added in just a drop of cell suds, which I've mentioned before I use for pretty much everything. And I've also added in a dollop of vinegar. I'm very precise with my measurements, as you can tell. If you're doing outdoor windows, you'll need an extension pole. I do have one, but for these type of windows, they're my favorite. They're the type that swing inward so that you can clean the outside and inside from inside, which I love. You'll need a squeegee set. This is the removable window washing pad that just goes on that thing. So you soak that with the warm water, soap, and vinegar mixture. And a squeegee. And also, I have a wet cloth that's wet with the same mixture, and I have a couple dry cloths, and the cloths I have are specifically like window polishing cloths, so streak free. And if you need it, if you just have a small window, for example, and you don't like, it's not big enough to need a squeegee, I have a squirt bottle with a mixture of water, cell sets, and vinegar in here. The other thing I have is a dry microfiber cloth, and I have a soft scrub pad if needed, and a scrub brush. This is mostly for the windowsill tracks. And in my pocket here, I have a razor blade, which don't be afraid to use when cleaning. Just make sure that you're using it wet. I don't think I'll have anything I need to use it on this window, but I made a short video on the last video that I cleaned in the other room, where I used the razor blade to scrape off some residue from the manufacturer stickers. So I'm cleaning windows, and there's some sticker residue. I soaked it, and I'm using a razor, and I'll take it right off. Look at that. So this is already wet with the cell suds and vinegar solution. I'm going to do the inside first. Okay. So when you have your squeegee, you should dry an edge first, so that starts on a dry edge. You can just take the dry cloth and get that. That. And then dry it with the dry cloth. So that's dry and leave some streaks. Use dry cloth to touch up any areas if need be. Okay. I'm using this wet cloth to wipe up the dirty water splashes and the sills. like the locking mechanism. Okay. And this side again, start with the dry edge. So I'm going to show you the magic of this type of window. Open it. First, make sure it's unlocked. Open it a bit. And then these little latches here. You have to pull this down and pull this one up at the same time. And then it swings out. Okay. Now that swings like that. And hopefully you can tell how dirty these are on camera. It's harder to see. And there's the tracks. So it's easier to clean up dirt than mud, so if there's a significant amount of dirt on the tracks, I'll dry dust it first. So I think because there's this window's closer to the road and also has bushes outside of it, this one is dirtier than the other ones were, so I'm going to wipe the track first. And if you notice a moment ago, I dry dusted the screen. There was some dirt stuck to it, and just wiping it with a dry cloth loosened all that dirt, and it just fell down. So now it's all clear. I would suggest using a vacuum for this. If you have one handy that has a brush attachment, it'd be easier than using a dry cloth to get all the dirt out of the... I'm going to use the wet cloth and... If there's anything really stuck on, you can use a razor blade. Always make sure that you're using it on a wet surface. with some milk. Always make sure you retract your blade as well so that you don't cut the track on this side. See the bushes outside the window? It's another reason I'm glad this one swings inside to clean, because that would be hard to get to if I had to go outside. I'm cleaning it over a hardwood floor so it's easy to wipe up the drips of water. But if you are cleaning windows over carpet, and that's when, so I like this, I suggest putting down a towel or a tarp or something. Now you can see through both windows. Make sure you wipe this if needed too, the sides there. But again, you squeeze this part up and down, and it comes back into place. If you do have to go outside to clean windows, I would suggest doing it without the sun directly hitting it, because then it dries it faster than you can wipe it, and it'll end up streaking. So overcast is actually best. You might not be able to see it on the camera, but this part of the window is still a bit dirty, so. Going to touch that up. Not sure if you can tell on camera. Before the floor got a little bit dirty, so I'm going to touch that up. I would suggest doing the windows before doing the floors. But they asked me to just do the windows today, so I'm just going to do the floor in the area that I've made it a mess. So I wiped that. Thanks for watching. If this video helped you out, please give it a like and subscribe for more content. Thanks.